Welcome to the session of Talking Tech, Women and Girls in ICT. My name is Reena Ashavadam, and today I'm delighted to be having a discussion about tech and tech careers with Priyanka Porwal, a Chief Development Architect, CTO Circle at SAP SuccessFactors. Talking Tech is a series celebrating girls and women in tech being recorded around the world between Girls in ICT Day 2020 and 2022. The objectives of Girls in ICT Day is to help create a global environment that empowers and encourages girls and young women to consider studies and careers in the growing field of ICT. This Talking Tech series is brought to you by the ITU, UNICC, and the Office of UN Secretary General's Envoy on Youth, and is in support of EQUALS, the global partnership of gender equality and the digital age. The goals of the series include interest and inspire girls and younger women with information about the range of ITC careers that can be had, bring before a broader audience some of the role model women in tech and share information about the career journey and work, offer diverse examples of how ICT is being used to support the achievement of the Sustainable Development Goals and other UN goals, showcase initiatives that are working with girls to support them in ICT studies or future ICT careers, provide girls and young women in tech with a leadership opportunity to represent and promote girls in tech organizations with which they are involved and promote it to a broader international audience. Before I go into the questions I have for you, Priyanka, I'd like to introduce myself. I am Reena, and I'm currently doing a bachelor's program in computer applications. I studied at Shanti Bhavan, a school that played a major part in making me who I am and is also the reason why I'm able to be here today. So a little bit of a Shanti Bhavan. It is a residential school and an NGO for underprivileged background children. So the vision of Shanti Bhavan is for families that are financially unstable to be able to see a brighter future by providing world-class education to one child of the family. They hope to see that one kid gets a job and uplifts the family. For more information, you can visit shantibhavanchildren.org. You can also check out the Netflix documentary, Daughters of Destiny. I was incredibly lucky to have had this opportunity to grow and study at Shanti Bhavan. I always believe that gender does not determine where you go, but rather your effort. Girls in ICT share similar goals about equality, and this is what made me want to be part of this. I'd like to shift my conversation to Priyanka. Hey, Priyanka, how are you?
Hi, Reena. I'm doing good, and hello to all the viewers too.
So can you tell me a little bit about yourself and how and when you got into technology?
So first of all, Reena, I must applaud and appreciate the organizers of Girls in Talking Tech series, whether it is ITU, UNICC, Envoy of Youth Program, and the SAP Women in Tech Program. It's a great opportunity to, in fact, learn and listen from the industry experts. And I'm also inspired with what Shanti Bhavan has been doing and, you know, how they are helping the underprivileged young women to achieve their dreams. This in turn will inspire many young women to consider the technical career path and be informed about the number of career choices they have in the technical career track. Now, coming to your question on how I got into technology. So it all started due to my father. My father actually comes from finance and cost accounting background. So one fine day, he just brought some programming books at home and learned it himself, wrote the programmings for his cost accounting work, and in fact, trained his entire department. So I used to go to his office and also play a game called as Digger. And it's really old. Probably some of you were not even born then. It kind of sat in my consciousness that, you know, this whole computer or the technology make life easier and make it fun, both in professional as well as personal life. In addition, my elder brother also graduated with top honors from BITS Pilani. And these two events kind of inspired me to also get onto the technology bandwagon.
That was a great introduction. You have had like a great life. Now, I'd like to know what your job is in tech now.
Sure. So I'm currently chief architect in SuccessFactors CTO Circle, and my job entails, you know, providing consistent enterprise architecture strategy, oversight, review, and governance across human experience management suite of products. That means products starting from, let's say, you know, publishing your job opening, recruiting, hiring, onboarding, then managing talent with, let's say, learning, goals, and continuous performance management, rewards and compensation, and payroll calculation, and offboarding. So, you know, so basically all the products for human experience management side of it to provide a delightful experience and also, you know, to help customers to run their business better.
Your job seems very interesting. It looks like you learn something new every day.
That's true.
Can you share something you have done in or with tech that you are particularly proud of?
So, Reena, it's been 23 years since, you know, I've been working. And there are many things when I look back, you know, which I feel proud about and feel a sense of accomplishment. Let's take, you know, whether it was delivering 17 different product enhancements for ERP HCM Canada in 1 year with a completely new freshers team and while carrying my first baby, or, you know, let's say localizing the SuccessFactors Employee Central product from 0 to 81 countries, or creating a unified permission solution for the human experience management suite of products, thus making the solution well integrated and an intelligent enterprise with embedded analytics, or being the first female chief architect into SAP Labs India, or being part of CTO Circle. So I when I look back, there are many such, you know, achievements which I feel proud about.
You are a very impressive role model.
Thank you, Reena.
Okay, now I heard a lot about what you like and your job, but I'd like to know outside of your job, do you have any activities that you enjoy that are outside your job?
So, Reena, I'm very passionate about, you know, women in tech. So as you grow in your career ladder, there is a leaky pipeline. So to that regard, I have been, you know, mentoring one or two colleagues every year. So if I can inspire them to consider the, you know, technical career path, I feel a sense of, you know, personal accomplishment. And it's also good for organization because, you know, it will help in creating a more diverse and inclusive work environment. In addition, I'm also a design thinking coach. So I love applying design thinking principles to address the end user needs. And since I work on the human experience management suite of products, design thinking principles are very much relevant here. On a more personal front, I have two daughters, and you know, their activities kind of also drive my day-to-day activities. And I also enjoy singing, and I like to conduct music trivia quiz shows.
That's very interesting. My next question for you is, have you encountered any challenges along the way? And if so, how did you overcome them?
Serena, I believe in the power of, you know, thinking. I can share a wisdom from Gautam Buddha, and he said that the mind is everything. So what you think, you become. What you feel, you attract. And what you imagine, you create. So you asked me challenges that I have faced and how I have overcome them. The challenges start right from your childhood. In fact, you know, your social background is very much relevant here. So I belong to a community where, you know, generally people used to go for business and not for higher studies. And this I'm talking, you know, at least 27 years back. Things have changed quite a lot now. But in those days, females were usually married off, you know, after the age of 18. In fact, I was quite lucky, and I was the first female, you know, in my family to go for engineering, go to another state, and also, you know, study in a hostel. And I graduated with 7 gold medals from different institutions. I was lucky that my parents always encouraged me to, you know, go for my dreams. Also, the career track which I have chosen, if you see the ratio wise, comparatively, there are not many women into, you know, the architect career path. In fact, I have often been the lone woman in the room, or let's say the lone woman on the stage presenting some sessions. In fact, in many organizations, the CTO circle is primarily a men's club. But I do believe that, you know, once you have proven yourself, once you have established your credibility, these things don't matter. And again, I have been very lucky that, you know, SAP has such a diverse and inclusive culture that, you know, SAP has always supported me. And I've had, you know, great leaders and great peers who always encouraged me to pursue my ambition. In fact, you know, the focus on diversity and inclusion at SAP is so high that it starts right from the hiring process to eliminate any gender bias or any sort of unconscious bias as well. Plus, there are also initiatives where, you know, employees are coached with some fireside chats or candid conversations with leaders from Business Women Network, as well as, you know, there are programs where early talent are encouraged to innovate and also become entrepreneurs. So there is a lot of focus on diversity and inclusion at SAP. Coming back to, you know, how I have overcome the challenges, it's thanks to this inclusive culture at SAP, plus the power of positive thinking. So had I chosen, let's say, the usual path, had I chosen the usual, you know, society norms or the usual thinking, I would not be here. So I really believe in the power of thinking to overcome any challenges.
I totally agree with you. Some place you get is totally based on your merit. It's not bias or anything. My next question for you is, since this series is about girls and women in technology, do you have any career or tech advice for younger women?
I sure love to. So the first advice which, you know, I would like to share with young women is think about the career choice which you would like to make. You know, this is the most important, decision which you can take. In fact, whenever I interact with my mentees or let's say if anybody approaches me for career guidance, this is the first question which I ask them is what makes you most happy, because that will kind of lead you towards your career choice. So there are some people who are very happy, you know, being in the system and thoroughly testing it, while some, you know, enjoy interaction with customers and the process of selling. Some may enjoy the delivery and the execution side of it. Similarly, there are people who enjoy, let's say, protecting the system and, you know, they get into the cybersecurity. Some like the intellectual property and become the technical patent lawyers. So the point here is there are many career choices which you have, but one needs to choose the career path which resonates with you the most. And personally, for me, it was always, you know, the whole creation process of, you know, timeless software and architecting and designing a solution which, will be used by end users for a long period of time. So that is why I say that, you know, think about the career choice which resonates with you most. And if you are starting your career and you're not clear, which one probably will suit you the most, choose an internship, you know, with that gets you at least an opportunity to experience these different career tracks. Like SAP has a beautiful internship and a scholars program wherein the scholars are assigned to a team for 6 months and then they are rotated to the next team. So this way they get to experience the different career choices as well as make an informed choice for their particular chosen career path. So think about the career choice. Yeah. Secondly, which I feel it's very much relevant for women, and that is be assertive. It's, I think, also due to the social conditioning, but it's important to make yourself heard. So you may have, let's say, you know, a very good solution for a difficult problem statement, or let's say you might be, you know, having an opinion which is against the popular choice. But if you don't express yourself, you keep silent, and if you do not, you know, say that thing assertively, someone else will do that on your behalf. So that is why I say that, you know, it's important to make yourself heard. Thirdly, you know, which is in fact a myth. And, you know, I whenever I talk with people, you know, I find that, you know, this is a wrong impression that people in technical career path need not bother about soft skills. So this is not true. And with experience, one realizes that soft skills are equally important for, you know, even the women in technical career path. So let's say communication skills, because, you know, you are moderating your communication depending on the stakeholder you are interacting with. Or not networking skills. So you might be, let's say, you know, learning best practices from other experts in your network or creating your own brand. Yeah. or let's say negotiation skills or influencing skills, you know, all these skills are still relevant for women in technical career path. In fact, I would also go to the extent of saying that, you know, having only technical skills do not make the leaders, but often styles and behavior do. So, you know, it's important that we pay equal attention and also cultivate on the soft skill side of it. Fourthly, I would say stay curious, stay hungry for knowledge and keep upskilling yourself, because that is very much, you know, needed in today's world. And last but not the least, and this is something, again, you know, I feel very much relevant for women, and that is appreciate yourself. And we women, you know, kind of tend to be perfectionist in nature, and our thinking process usually starts from that maybe, you know, I could have done this better. Well, that may be true, and there are always areas of improvement, but I still think that, you know, it's important to step back and see where you started from, what were the challenges you faced, and how did you, you know, overcome those challenges and made certain accomplishments. So do take, you know, time to step back and acknowledge yourself and appreciate yourself. In fact, there is a, you know, nice movement also called as I Am Remarkable, and you can search for this hashtag I Am Remarkable on social media. And that kind of, you know, encourages people to share your accomplishments both in personal and professional life with somebody else. So that way, you know, you kind of, you know, start thinking about appreciating yourself. So that is what I would like to share with the young women to, you know, start appreciating yourself.
Thank you for that advice. I'll really try to implement it in my life. Sure, those are the questions I have for you. Do you have any questions for me?
Oh, sure. In fact, Reena, I'm quite impressed with you, and I've been, you know, interacting with you for this interview, and I see your energy and your enthusiasm and your drive to make that difference. So I would like to know from you that, you know, how did you get into technology and what do you like most about it?
Okay, so I first got into technology, not through computers, but like first basic problem solving. I really enjoyed solving problems. And then when I came to ninth grade, there's a friend of mine who was at that time my substitute teacher. He would come in class and he would give us, his name is Nanda Gopal. So he'd come into class and he understood that we were ninth graders and like full of energy. So he'd give us programming problems, but something that would make us think, something that would like keep us quiet for a bit. But I really enjoyed it, and that was my first impression of computers and problem solving, and I think that's what is keeping me continuing in this field.
That's a good to know. So what do you, you know, you would like to give as a message to other young women in tech, or maybe not so young women in tech, and you know, also into the industry?
I think the best advice I can give anyone is try. It's okay to like fail. It's okay to not feel secure, but like everyone is figuring things out. When you put yourself out and you fail so many times, there's so many opportunities for you to learn. Say you're getting everything right, then there's no chance of you learning or like seeing a different perspective of a problem. So I think failure is a great opportunity to learn, and you should take it positively. So that would be my advice to girls or young women entering the tech field.
I love that thought, you know, because it's okay to fail. Yes. Thomas Alva Edison said that, you know, when 100 times he was not able to, you know, get his bulb working, it's just not that I have failed 99 times. I've learned the ways, you know, how it will not work for those 99 times. So there is always some learning associated, even if, you know, things don't go your way. So very rightly said, Reena. In fact, I wish you all the best. I do believe that you will go places in your career. So I wish you good luck for a lifetime, you know, that is filled with accomplishments in both personal and professional life.
Thank you so much. I wish the same for you. That wraps up our session of Talking Tech for today. It was lovely talking to you, Priyanka. And thank you so much, viewers, for watching.
Thank you, Reena. It's been my pleasure.